Good morning, YouTube. Welcome back to The Truth According to Lily. I am your host, Lily. This is back by unpopular demand, and I messed up, and I have to apologize. Last year, I made a video detailing some of my favorite Christmas movies, and towards the end of that video, I said this.
So yeah, that's been my Christmas list. What is yours? What are some of your favorite movies?
And when I made that video, I thought that list had been complete. I thought it was like, yeah, these are all the Christmas movies that I like to watch around this time of year. And I was so wrong. And I'm so sorry that I did not include the following two movies. All right, so this is totally a clickbait video. So you can leave if you're pissed at me, but you can stay if you want to know what these two movies are. So yeah, last year I made this video and I was just like, oh yeah, this is great. And I rewatched it, you know, right before posting. Cause you know, I always try and like do as much editing and rewatch as possible to make sure that I have like a good, decent video to post. I was like, yeah, that's perfect. It's fine. And then I realized I had forgotten two of my favorite Christmas movies and I feel like such a dumbass. So we're just gonna talk about those really quick. Also, it snowed.
They said snow!
Yesterday and into this morning, and it's like a little winter wonderland. We only got like 3 inches of snow. It's really not that big of a deal.
They said snow!
I'm going out later to get a haircut because even though I'm rocking this really cute pixie, like Romulan Vulcan style haircut, I'm like, it needs to go. I need it gone. The first movie we're going to talk about is Scrooged. And what's funny is that I mentioned A Christmas Carol last year and I should have remembered because Scrooged is basically A Christmas Carol. I love this movie. I've been watching this movie every year since I was very, very young, probably since it came out. My parents love Bill Murray. And yeah, it's so funny. It's a very funny, funny movie. It literally follows the same exact beats and themes as everything in A Christmas Carol. And Bill Murray is so abundantly hysterical, like not even just like hysterically funny. He's just a hysterical person when all of this stuff starts happening.
No picking! Sometimes the truth is painful, Frank, but it's made your cheeks all rosy and your eyes bright as stars.
If you touch me again, I'm gonna rip your goddamn wings off. Okay.
All of the ghosts are really great. All of the comedians that were popular. Robert Mitchum is in this movie. I personally like Robert Mitchum as an actor. And so it's really funny to see him in this role of a studio executive. And he kicks a cat at one point, which I don't endorse whatsoever. Please don't kick any animals. But you have to watch the scene to understand the context of why he kicks a cat. And it's so horrible. Yeah, I just love this movie. It's so funny. It's a great Christmas movie. It's actually kind of really creepy at times because I kind of am of the mind that Christmas Carol is actually a horror story. And yeah, I just love everybody who's in it. It's got some really great names, some really great faces.
Who's that? She's pretty.
She's dead, Frank.
Specifically, you can see her nipples.
I want to see her nipples.
But this is a Christmas show.
Well, Charles Dickens would have wanted to see her nipples then.
You can hardly see them nipples.
See, and these guys are really looking.
So I highly recommend Scrooge with Bill Murray and literally everyone from the 90s. This is a movie in my family that we could literally quote to each other. Like, my family has a weird sort of movie language where we'll just start quoting movies back and forth to each other and we'll do like an entire scene and it's just a whole thing because movies were a big, big deal in my childhood. And last, but certainly not least, A Long Kiss Goodnight. This movie stars Gina Davis and Samuel L. Jackson and it is written by Shane Black and it is directed by Renny Harlin. I do have my computer open. It only has a 6.8 on IMDb. Please do not let the IMDb rating fool you. This is a fantastic film. Gina Davis is such a badass. She ice skates and shoots a gun at one point. She's just super awesome. She assembles a sniper rifle of some kind at one point. Like, Gina Davis did that to herself. She just assembles it like super fast. Basically, the premise of the movie is this woman, Samantha, lives in this really small town and everyone loves her. She's on the PTA. She has a kid. She's got like a white bread kind of unattractive boyfriend, but they're happy and she's just like happy being a mom and making arts and crafts and baking cookies and being in the Christmas parade. But what she doesn't know is that she actually is suffering from amnesia and she is actually a super awesome badass spy. That's really cool. It's really cool watching her morph back into like her real personality when bits of it start kind of coming back to her because she gets into this car accident on like after like a Christmas party. She's doing the right thing. She's driving an old drunk guy home and they get into a car accident because he distracts her while she's driving and I believe she hits a deer. It's so horrible. She hits the deer. She goes off the road. She stumbles out of the car. She's got like just blood dripping down her face. And this is her as like Samantha, the woman that she's been unknowingly basically pretending to be. And she sees the deer lying there and it's in pain and it's like gasping for air. And she goes up to it and she kind of like touches it. And mind you, at this point in the film, we've only ever seen her be like a super nice mom. She grabs the deer by the antlers and snaps its neck. And then she just collapses. And it's so gruesome and it's so horrifying. And that kind of is the, it kind of shakes her into starting to recall memories of her earlier life. And it's this whole thing. Samuel Jackson is basically a shitty former cop for whatever reason. I think she hires him to be her private investigator to try and figure out her past a little bit. Yeah, so they go on this adventure and the dialogue is very Shane Black. Gina Davis and Samuel L. Jackson have phenomenal chemistry.
Fuck it! Run for your life!
Some parts of the movie have not aged particularly well. There is a scene where a guy is trying to pick up Gina Davis after she's turned back into her alter ego or her real personality. And he's like, hey baby, you want a good time? And she says,
no thanks, I'm saving myself till I get raped.
So that has not aged well at all. I'm like, Gina, Shane, boo, I personally don't think that dialogue has aged well myself. The ending is slightly gratuitous. It is a very long movie. I think it's 2.5 hours, but it does take place around Christmas and it is a fun Christmas movie. If you can get past some of the dialogue that has not aged well and just enjoy the action-packed thriller that it is, it's a very fun movie and I highly recommend it. And again, Gina Davis ice skating and shooting a gun, I think maybe even two guns, is just great. You know, Gina Davis has that like, she has that action, female action hero body type that I really, really like. Not that women who are maybe built more like me can't be a badass, but like women like Charlize Theron or Angelina Jolie, Gina Davis, they have these, they're tall and they kind of have this like really intense masculine feminine energy where they walk in and you're like, yeah, they've got the biggest dicks in the room. Charlize Theron has mad big dick and energy. Those are the women that I'm just like, yeah, I can just like grab a bottle and just beat you across the face with it. It's just like, yeah.
Were you always this stupid or did you take lessons?
I took lessons. Hey, what? I still got this fucking gun.
Or even like, I hated Terminator Dark Fate, but Mackenzie Davis's body in that movie is just so like, not, she is just so beautifully like sculpted. She looks like a brick shit house. And no, this is not me just saying the women are only great because of their bodies. No, they're physically amazingly fit. But yeah, this is just my quick little apology Christmas video. I'm sorry I did not include these last year. Not that anybody asked me to. Also yesterday, I revisited Beauty and the Beast, Enchanted Christmas. So let's just talk about that one really quick. Because this video isn't long enough, right? So I remember renting Beauty and the Beast, Enchanted Christmas from the library when I was a kid. Because I was like, what? There's a Beauty and the Beast like sequel? What? So I rented it, we watched it, and I was just like, what? I didn't know what sequels, prequels, or midquels were. So I never watched it again because it was just so strange and it wasn't what I was expecting. I don't know what I was expecting at like 10, 11, 12 years old. But I revisited it yesterday on Disney Plus and I was like, well, this actually isn't a bad movie. Some of the stuff is kind of stupid. Don't really remember why the axe is Jewish. That was kind of weird. Some of the newer characters are just kind of lame, but I forget what her name is, but she's like basically the Christmas decorator and she's like the Christmas topper or the Christmas tree topper. And I love her. She's just kind of like a snooty little French lady and I think she's great. The majority of the cast came back to do the sequel, which to me was just like, okay, they wanted to come back, I guess. Like everyone except Chip came back because the kid who played Chip like aged out basically, like his voice changed. So they got Haley Joel Osment to come and play Chip's voice because I was listening to it and I was like, that voice sounds really familiar when I close my eyes. I think Belle still makes some really dumb decisions at times. Like she goes out into, like this is taking place after the wolf attack in the first movie, but she still goes out into a dark forest where there's wolves. Like Belle, did you learn nothing? Did you learn nothing? But Tim Curry as Forte is iconic. He's so fabulous. He's so wonderful. He's amazing. He fits in so well. And him is just like this angry composer who got turned into an organ and then got crushed under his own weight or something like that. I kind of forget. The music in this movie is absolutely terrible. Enchanted Christmas has some of the worst musical numbers I have ever heard in any Disney movie. They all sound, I tweeted this, that they all sounded like rejects that had been sitting in a drawer for 50 years and they just pulled them out and like maybe redid them a little bit. But other than that, I thoroughly enjoyed it. I was watching it yesterday when I had a horrible migraine and I felt better after watching it. But yeah, that's all I've got for today. Those are some of my Christmas movie recommendations. We got Scrooge, The Long Kiss Goodnight, Beauty and the Beast, and Enchanted Christmas if you want something stupid and but entertaining and fun. And it's pretty harmless for the most part. It's the most harmless out of any probably Christmas movie I will recommend to watch, except for the fact that there is a Jewish character that's an axe and has a very large face. So there is that. Didn't care for that. That's all I've got for today. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. Peace and long life. And stay tuned and turn on for more. I have to go and see A Nativity. Things I Do for Love. Wish me luck. I think it's a musical. And they're all like 11 years old. Hey, my parents had to go and see me in some pretty shitty plays when I was 11 to 12 years old. I guess I like them.